Okay, hi everyone, welcome back to another video. Today's video is going to be another updated review on the movie Heroes, episode 1, Queen Amidala. This is going to probably slow down my updated reviews. I do have a few updated request reviews I will be doing, and then after that I'm probably going to try to come up with some new videos, because I can't update every review I've done on my channel. And I'm only doing figures that I feel that need updates, especially the ones I did way back when I first started my channels. I feel a lot of those videos need updated reviews because they're just not good videos. So I just wanted to do this review. If you have any requests for updated reviews, I'll always do them, but I'm going to try to gear into other kinds of videos for a little while. Just that way you guys don't get bored of seeing updated reviews and doing other videos. So let's get started. We'll start with the packaging. This Padme figure came in two different things. We'll start with the first time she came out, and that was a part of the movie Heroes Wave 2 line. Now, this came out back in, I just want to make sure, 2012. It says 2011, but it actually came out in 2012. I remember, I think, she came out, the other figures in this series about around February of 2012, and there was Darth Maul, Qui-Gon, Jar Jar Binks, Anakin Skywalker, and Obi-Wan Kenobi, and I didn't find her until about, I want to say this time in 2012, around May something, and so she was pretty hard to find because not enough of the series was put out in stores, and series one's clogged up all the pegs and stuff, which was series one wasn't the best line, so it took me forever to get her. Now she's pretty cheap online, you can find her easy, but then she was pretty tough to find on a single card. But let's take a look at the packaging. You get a Darth Maul picture right there, Star Wars logo, image of Queen Amidala, Padme right there, the figure, and it says includes Galactic Battle Game card, die, and base, a read-up if you want to pause and read, a image of Padme and Qui-Gon, an image of the prototype figure, image of what the figure does, information about the battle game card, and the other figures in the wave. I actually have all these figures except Anakin. I never got Anakin, but I'm sure Anakin is much easier to find now. And Hasbro information right there. If you want her now, she's pretty easy to find, I'm sure. I haven't looked because I have her both loose and carded, but back in 2012, she was one of the harder figures to find, and I was so excited to find her. I found her and Obi-Wan at a Walmart. Just him and her were on the pegs, and I got them both. Then, the second release was this pack for Episode 1. It came out in 2014, it says, but I actually found this last year, I'm pretty sure. It was funny how I came across this. I was, looking at them, and I saw the Episode 3 one, and I really wanted it because of Sidious, because Sidious is also one of my favorite characters. And then I looked down, and I saw Padme, and I just got it. It is, the exact same Padme figure, right there, as the Movie Heroes one. I mean, maybe a few different, maybe the face sculpt is a little different, but it's the same molding. It comes with the same accessories except the battle game card and die. And she comes with Darth Maul, Battle Droid, and R2-D2. I kind of, thought it was funny that they added her and not like Qui-Gon. I'm really glad they did, but it's sad because when you get all of them, you can make a kind of a poster. And she's not even on the back of this, which is kind of lame. But I can, yeah, so. So, you should actually still be able to find this in stores. And, so yeah, so that's one way of getting this Padme figure as well. So yeah, so we're gonna move her, the boxes aside and, get on with the review. So, we'll start off with Padme's articulation. She has a ball jointed head, swivel on the shoulders, ball hinge elbows, swivel on the waist, and swivel on the hips. So for a, like, movie hero's figures, pretty nice articulation, even though she doesn't have ball hinge knees, which is, oh well, but, the detail is pretty nice on her battle dress. The texturing is nicely done. It's kind of a glossy finish on her. And the sculpt of her outfit is really nicely done as well. Her pants are nicely sculpted as well as her boots, which are also a glossy paint. And you can see her belt right there. And you can see the gold lines going through her outfit, like in the movie. And her hair does have nice sculpt. It's pretty much just all one color, but it's still nicely sculpted. And you can see her sleeves right here. The face sculpt, I don't really think looks like Natalie Portman. Hasbro has a hard time getting Natalie Portman's face sculpt down, but it looks like maybe an older version of Natalie Portman. She doesn't really look 14 here. She looks more like 20 here or something. But you can see she has lipstick on, and yeah, so pretty nice. Her accessories, she can stand pretty well, but she does come with a base. I don't use base for my movie figures. I use them for my Clone Wars figures, so. But she does come with a base if you would like to display her that way. She does come with a blaster. This is not, her pistol. Naboo pistol. She actually doesn't come with a Naboo pistol. She comes with this. There's a reason she comes for this, but she looks, it, looks pretty nice in her hand. And she also comes with a zip line, and that's one reason she comes with this gun. I don't display it. I used to display her with it, but I don't really anymore. But it's nicely sculpted, but you can either, you can actually put, if you take the zip line, you can actually put the blaster in the hole right there. And, you can take this plug, and she has a hole on her back, and you can actually plug it into her back, like so. I mean, it's pretty cool. Actually, I might just start displaying her this way again. I actually did like her displayed this way. Or you can take this part of the zip line, and you can put the blaster in this one if you want as well. Which I'm not sure what this purpose is for. So I think the hook is more, makes more sense. Like so. Even though she didn't really use this in the movie. So and she also comes with a really, now I've never played the games, but I always really like the cards, and this is the only Padme card we got in the game, and there's her abilities. And a really nice image of Padme right there. Interesting, because if you look on the box, it says Padme Amidala right there, but then it says Queen Amidala on the box. We all know, you know, Queen Amidala is Padme's. I just found that interesting, excuse me. So there's that. And then you get a dice, and I really don't know what to do with all the dice. I still have all my dice in my weapon drawer. But there's all the symbols. And this is the image right there. You can actually take them out and do whatever with them. I still have my original one, but that's what that is right there. So I am going to bring in the original zip line Padme. I was going to bring in the original battle dress Padme, but she doesn't come with a zip line. I'm just getting her a zip line back in or an extension gun. So this is the original one. Not the best Padme figure, honestly. I'm gonna actually take the zip lines and compare them, but here is a look at the Padmes together. I think obviously the movie Heroes Padme face sculpt is a lot better. It looks, I mean, it's compared, it looks more like Natalie Portman than the original one. I really never thought this face sculpt was that great. I only have her because she's Padme. But one thing I do really like about this figure is she has soft goods. So there's a comparison between them. Overall, the movie Heroes sculpt is a lot better. And then here is a comparison between the zip lines. I'm pretty sure this one's more movie accurate. This is how it looked in the movie. It really never looked like this in the movie. But there is a comparison between them. And really, all you do with this one is just put it in her hand and have her looking up. And this one actually makes it better. If you're doing like a diorama or display, this one makes a better figure for the diorama and display because it's more movie accurate. The sculpt's just not that great. So I am going to plug her back in. And I'm going to put the blaster back in. And also, if you do play the game, you can actually put the card in through there. And that's how you kind of store the card. If you know you have a shelf space, it would be cool to like display the figure with the card. But unfortunately, since I don't use bases for my movie figures and I don't have a lot of shelf space, the cards just are in storage right now. But that's how you do it. And you could always put the dice, next to the figure as well. So that is going to be it on this Padme. If you don't have this Padme, I definitely, and you want a battle Padme, I would definitely get the original first episode one battle dress Padme. I think that's a better sculpt than this one. The proportions on this Padme are good, but I think the original one is better. But of course, if you're a huge diehard Padme fan like I am, you're probably gonna wanna get all of the battle dress Padmes. But I definitely I like her. I do like her. She's not my favorite, but I do like her. And I am glad to have her in my collection, obviously. If you have any more requests on Padme figures you want to see, let me know and I'll do them. I wasn't planning to do any more, I was just gonna do this one. But if you want to see other updated Padme reviews, I will be more than glad to do them. As well as on other any oh, I am mixing up words there. As well on other any other figure reviews as well. So that's gonna do it for this review. Today we were taking a look at the Movie Heroes Padme Amidala or Queen Amidala figure. Again, she was also packed in this pack too, but she was originally first put out on the Movie Heroes card. If you want her, she should be pretty cheap to find now. So thank you for watching. Please subscribe to my channel and like this video and have a great day. Okay, you guys made it to the end of the video. Thank you for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Remember, you guys can follow me on the social media links I have in my channel and down below. And I also do have a fan mail address if you would like to send fan mail
feel free to do so. And I hope you guys enjoyed this review. Please subscribe to my channel and have a great day. Bye.